Hi everyone and welcome back to the Organized Notebook. In this video, we wanted to show you how to make a contact tracker with Notion, and we'll also show you some ways to incorporate AI into this template, so let's get started. First, start by opening an empty Notion page, and let's call this contact tracker. And we're going to add an icon by clicking add icon, and we'll go to Notion's icon library and find something for person. And let's choose one here. And let's go ahead and add a cover photo by pressing add cover. And we're going to go to change cover. And we'll go to Unsplash, which has a huge library of stock images. And we will choose something with a nice view. Let's go with this one. And reposition. Save position. And now let's go ahead and click the top three dots on the right corner, and we're going to do small text full width so we have more space on the page. So now we can start designing the contact tracker, and for this we're just going to go with one database where we put all our contacts. So we're just going to click empty page and go ahead and press slash database, and we're going to choose table view and plus new database. And let's call it my contacts. And let's go ahead and hide the database title so that it looks a bit cleaner. So we're going to go to the three dots here, and we're going to go to layout and toggle off show database title. And now we can go ahead and decide what properties we want in our contact tracker. So name is already a default here, and we definitely need name. And instead of tags, we could put something like connection so that we can see what kind of connection we have with this person. So it can be family, it could be work, could be university. And if you want to change the color, you can click the three dots next to it and choose another option. And since it's a multi-select, you can add multiple things. So if it was also friend, you could put friend and work so you know that it's a work friend. So this could be useful just so that you know what kind of connection you have with this person. And after connection, it would be good to know their birthday, for example. So we could put date and birthday. And we could just put a cake icon here. And next we can put date first met. Actually, we could do first met so that you can keep track of when you met the person for the first time. And for this, we need to choose date property first, and then we can rename it first met. And then we can add last contacted. And again, it's a date property and last contacted. So this can help you keep track of people you might fall out of contact with so that you can keep in constant contact or at intervals that you feel like is good for that relationship. And then we can put also occupation so that you know what kind of job this person does. So multi-select for the property, and you can rename it occupation. So let's say that you're looking for someone in order to start your business, and you just need someone who has an occupation of a accountant, and maybe you know someone within your contacts. So it could be useful to have occupation there for that reason. And next we can put a multi-select again. And this time you can add a rating for how close you feel with this person. So for this, we can choose multi-select, rename it closeness. And let's add the options here. And for this, we like to add star rating. So we could put slash emoji and then star. And we can just copy this here and create. And we could just put two like this. And so you can choose how close you are with the person. So you can gauge how often you should interact with them. And then we have So we have connection, birthday, first met, last contacted, occupation, and now we should also add their contact information, which is very important. So phone, we need their email. We should add a URL in case they have some kind of website, and physical address. And we could put a house here. And that's basically it for all of the properties. And depending on your needs, you might not need certain properties, or you might want to add other properties yourself. So this is just up to you, but we just are going to go with these for now. And now you'll notice that when we scroll like this, we lose track of who this line is for. So actually what's really good is to freeze the column. And this is a relatively new update, but you can click on name and then you can click freeze up to column. And what this is going to do is that when you scroll like this, you can still keep track of who it's about. So this is very useful. So now what we should do is just fill in a couple contacts so that we can start doing other things with this database. So let's just add some new contacts. Great, so now we have a lot of it filled in. So now we can start working on how to display this data. So we can rename this view all. And now what we can do is show you how to also view this in a gallery view. So you can click here and then click duplicate, and we can change the layout here into gallery view. So this is really useful if you have trouble remembering people's names. And we can change the card preview to page cover. And then you could add a cover photo here, change cover. And for now, we'll just put a placeholder. So for example, it would look like this, so you can see exactly what people look like, so you can remember their names. And we can call this gallery view. And if you want to add additional information underneath each person, you could go to properties here and choose to show, for example, their birthday, your closeness, your connection, and so on. So you could only just have name, or you could add all sorts of other properties to it. And then after that, what we can also show you is to how to see who you contacted last. So for that, we're going to duplicate this and we'll say view all by last contacted. And we'll add a sort, and we want to sort it by last contacted. And we are going to sort it descending. Actually ascending, so that you can see the oldest last contacted. And then click save for everyone. So this way you can keep track of who you last contacted and who maybe you should refresh your contact with. And then what we want to show you now is how to add a sub template inside this database. So if we go here to this arrow and click plus new template, you can add new contact entry. And what's interesting is that you can actually start adding various outlines here so that it gets copied for every single contact you have. So for example, you might want a description of the person. You might want to know what you did when you last met. You can keep track of their likes and dislikes. And finally, you can actually use Notion's AI in order to determine what kind of gifts that person might like. And this could really save you the hassle of when the gift giving season comes. So gift ideas here. And you can type slash AI, and you can do a block, custom AI block. And here we can ask AI to write, what would be a good gift for this person? And now it could just be a thing that generates based on what's written here. So now we can add headings here. So turn into heading 3, turn into heading 3. And now we can see what happens when we go back. So now if we open this contact and we click new contact entry, we will get the template we just created. And we can go ahead and update this when you change things here. So for example, we know that this person likes cats, this likes dogs, doesn't like pasta. So now we can click here and then click update. And it tells you some ideas on what you can give for this contact. So this could be really useful if you have Notion AI. And if you're interested in upgrading, we'll leave a link in the description below. And if you do decide to upgrade through the link, that will support us at no cost to you. So definitely consider upgrading AI. We really like this feature that you can just kind of embed AI everywhere into Notion. So this is a really cool way to use it. And for this area, you could, for example, put what you did last time you met. So if it was just to keep track of what you did. And here you could put your background with this person. So this is a really great way to keep track of your contacts. And then you can also see that because you have all of these properties, that it's very easy to sort of sort through your contacts as well. So if you needed to only see people who are your family, for example, you could also filter and go to connection and filter see only family like this and save for everyone. So you could make various tabs of the different filters that you like to see, or just filter whenever you need to, like so. So that's the basics of creating a contact tracker with Notion, and we'll leave the link to the completed version of this template that we made during this tutorial for your reference in the description. And let us know if you have any questions, comments, or anything that was confusing during this tutorial, and we hope to see you in the next one.